Hello student, welcome to my class of computer for class 10th. In this video student, we are going to understand internet security, in which we will cover need of internet security, cyber threats like phishing, email spoofing, chat spoofing, etc. So let's begin. Here you can see the session number 8 covers the internet security. As we know student, internet actually represents an insecure channel for exchanging information, and that definitely leading the high risk of the intrusion and fraud such as phishing. So internet security is a branch of computer security, especially it is related to the internet, often involving the browser security, also network security. Its objective to establish the rule and measure to use against the attackers, I would say attack over the internet. So this session introduces you to internet security concepts and how to secure online and network transactions. Through the internet, definitely we will get the valuable information and entertainment. It definitely may leave your computer insecure due to many online threats. So here threat means some kind of program, application that will damage your program, I mean to say computer. You definitely need to ensure that username and password of credit card or online banking information should be secure, as they are prone to attack and used to unauthorized user. There are a lot of users like hacker and crackers are on the network which try to chase your data information to get the information and your bank card details also. Some websites definitely also install the malware on your computer without your consent by leaving the computer damaged or insecure. Online threats such as phishing, email spoofing, chat spoofing, etc. definitely increase the chances of your getting system compromised. So you can reduce the risk by best practice such as antivirus, anti-spyware software, firewall, strong password, etc. In addition to spreading the awareness of best practice, we are giving here the best security practice for you. So first of all, we will talk about the password. So you have to use strong password. A strong password in concern of you will have a such type of password that is not easy to guess by the hacker or cracker, or it is not easy to crack by or access by the particular cracker or hacker person. To do that, you have to do not keep password such as your favorite color name, friend or relative name, bike number, mobile number, etc. Either it is a single or the combined option also. These passwords are definitely easy to guess if a user knows your person. Okay, so you need to just change your password frequently, at least 2 or 3 months, I mean to say week, okay, to secure your account. Using the strong password can be definitely lower your risk as security branches, okay, and its effectiveness to password to depends on your security mechanism of the software. So user involve the generating strong password also. So most websites check the password effectiveness when the user attempt to register in first time. So as you notice, a student in figure number 337. So if you are going to type a password, it will show you this particular message like weak, strong, very strong, or invalid. So most of the website will also provide you the facility to keep your password strong way. So we have to follow this rule. And if you are not able to create your difficult password, you can just note down these points. So first point, keep length of your password definitely 12 to 14 character if permitted, okay, because some website not permitting you long password, minimum I think 8 digit or 6 digit. So you have to keep, you have to try to keep your password long, up to 12 or 14 character if it is permitted. Next one thing, avoid keeping your password based repetition, dictionary word, letter or number, sequence, username, relative to pet name, etc. So don't need to pass PM, say use such password which is like pet name, relative name, username, etc. So don't have to repeat the same password. Including, you have to include your numbers, symbols, password if it is allowed. Use definitely capital and lowercase letter, that means say small a and capital A may be possible. Avoid using the same password for multiple site or purposes, because if you are using the same password for every website or every user ID, so it may be cause bigger damage for you. Avoid using the something that public or workmate know, strongly like dislike password. Use random password generate if it is possible. For example, you can see this is a example of password, that is u1v capital x colon comma core hd curly braces square bracket and dollar. So this may be definitely not easy to remember, but it will secure your computer and it will secure your account also. You definitely type this one thing, otherwise you can go to this website to generate the password, that is www.strongpasswordgenerator.com. That will generate your random password and a strong password, and you will just type this particular website in your computer browser, and you will follow the some steps to create your password. Once this particular website will open in your browser, then after that you will click on generate password, and notice that password display under new password. Backup your data. Always keep your copy of the personal data and additional media such as the compact disc, pen drive, etc. This could be helpful for in your situation when there is a loss of data. Keep your data away from the unauthorized user. Use definitely encrypted software. Actually, this is usually available within the operating system, that is encryption method, but you can use your encrypted software also to protect the data from unauthorized access. If it is encrypted or encryption software is not available within the operating system, you can use third party software also. Third party software means you can purchase from the internet, or you can use any software that should be license proofed. Keep your username and password private. Never save your username or password on your computer that you use in your shared environment, such as internet cyber cafe. Browser may save your personal data on a local computer that can be used by another and using same password. In such case, what happen? You are normally using your password and ID in cyber cafe. In cyber cafe, a lot of user are accessing that particular computer. Anyone can copy that one thing, or any program can attack by the hacker or cracker also. Registering with the website. So read the privacy and statement of policy whenever you register yourself website. This statement of policy will include the information about how to website our personal data. Do not share personal information website required for you fill out the form containing fields such as name, gender, age, email address, school, etc. There are a lot of website students which ask you your Gmail ID, I mean to say email ID, and your password. So do not need to share that time your email ID and password, like your name, gender, age, email address, school, etc. So you have to be in a cautious, okay, when you are filling out the forms. Research and verify it is troubleshoot website, okay, trustable website, and you will your email address could not be used by another one person. So student, we have learned today what are the precautions by which you can secure your computer in the term of user ID and password. And next time we will learn the other aspect of securing your data, I am to say secure yourself in internet security. Till then student, thank you, and have a nice day.